Nos acompañan Olia y Elena de Saiga Conservation Alliance, un antílope muy inusual adaptado en el desierto central de Asia y Rusia. Cuéntanos, ¿cuál es su misión?
Our mission is to restore an amazing species, Saiga antelope, at its common status of flagship species of steppe and semi-desert.
So obviously the main goal is to protect the Saiga antelope, but also we care about the wildlife that lives around the Saiga in the same habitat. So I would say our main goals are to protect the Saiga, to protect the habitat, and to protect other animals that live within this habitat.
¿Cuáles son las características del antílope?
Saiga is ungulate species, only antelope species that inhabited in Eurasian continent. It's not surprising that Saiga inhabited in huge flat areas. We call it steppe. It looks like savanne. And the semi-desert, it's huge grasslands and Gladi desert. They give chance to Saiga to run away for the very long distance. And maybe most funny and more visual feature of Saiga is big nose.
It's important to understand that Saigas live in a very extreme climate. So in the winter, the temperature can go below 58 degrees Fahrenheit, which is super cold. So in such harsh climate conditions, Saigas use their noses to heat up the air as a heater during the winter time. But then in summer, the temperature goes up and it can go up to 122 degrees, which is the other extreme. So, and since the Saiga lives in a desert and it's quite dusty there, so during the summer they need to filter the air. So in this case, nose helps them to filter the air that comes inside as they need it when they run. And they run quite fast with the speed of a car, so you can imagine.
¿Cómo se pueden involucrar la gente para poder ayudar a estas especies?
For us, it's crucial to spread awareness in different regions, in different corners of the world, so people know about this animal. And it can be done in many different ways, and there are so many different ways to get involved. So if our viewers simply check our website, which is saigaconservation.org, that would help and they can find more information, or if they can just spread the word or share our pictures, etc., etc. That's something that is really helpful. Also, it's important to just be aware of different things that happen in wildlife to other species.
It may be timely now started think about it, come back to our root and started care about wildlife, not only because we are philanthropes, we good people that would like to have good food, but only because we are part of this wildlife, because we need care about wildness, because we are part of wildness and we would like to have a good future for whole ecosystem of yours.
Y recuerden, si quieren saber más sobre estos temas, ingresen a nuestra página web hitn.tv. Yo soy Ana Osorio y esto es Tu Planeta.